We've been talking about things that are novel. Things that are actually novel and are having a true impact here is a company called Illumina. Our listeners will recognize them as the gene sequencing giant. That's ticker symbol ILMN. They made big news on the M&A front also last week, announcing a big deal to acquire a smaller competitor. I'm excited, Todd. You're finally starting to see the M&A ramp up. It has been really quiet, especially after so much hype went into 2018 with the impacts of tax reform. Oh, all the biotechs, all the pharmaceutical companies would do M&A. We're finally getting some noteworthy deals here.
Yeah, and this is, to me, this was a very surprising deal. I mean, Pacific Biosciences has been around a long time. Illumina's been around a long time, but they operate in slightly different parts of the gene sequencing market. And, you know, PacBio has really just kind of been an, I don't want to say afterthought company, but it's a much, much smaller company than Illumina. Illumina makes gene sequencers that represent about 90% of all of the gene sequencing that's been done, you know, since the Human Genome Project in the 1990s. So it is absolutely 100% a Goliath. It's got over 11,000 of its gene sequencing machines installed globally, and its sales are anticipated to eclipse $3 billion this year. When you put that in perspective, PacBio, their sales last quarter were only $18 million. So, you know, they've got less than a $100 million run rate compared to $3 billion run rate, and they have a fraction of the penetration that Illumina has within these researchers and these drug companies and these academic institutions and such that are doing all of this really, really fascinating next generation work in evaluating the genes in our body, in figuring out, you know, how to apply those lessons learned to things like medications that could really just move the needle on outcomes.
Yeah, and this was a surprising deal, but if you think about it, it kind of makes strategic sense when you look at the different tech behind the two companies. So Illumina has really been dominant on short read sequencing, and really for PacBio, it's been long reads. And if you think about genomic sequencing, it's a bit like, to use a metaphor that one of our colleagues used, it's like a jigsaw puzzle. Long reads allow researchers to have fewer puzzle pieces that they have to put together. And so for Illumina, it actually makes a lot of sense to not only dominate in the short reads, but now be able to take these complex pieces of genomic sequencing data, put them together, and hopefully solve some of the more complex gene therapy issues that we've been seeing as well.
Yeah, I think that, you know, whenever you research anything or do anything, a lot of times, you know, you can get the gist of it by doing, spending less time on it, right? So that would be kind of like short read, okay? Oh, it was functional, it's quick. In case of Illumina sequencing, it's a lot cheaper than long read. Now, long read is like doing a deep dive into a subject matter and finding out absolutely everything that you can possibly find out about it. In the past, you really haven't needed to have that level of granularity in gene sequencing. However, as we get more and more involved in things like gene editing and really sophisticated gene therapies that are extremely targeted, it's becoming more and more important to have as thorough a look at the DNA and the RNA as possible to make sure that you're not having any off-target suffering any off-target events or anything else. And also in the design of those drugs. And I think that what Illumina is saying is, okay, we absolutely dominate the long read space, the short read space. And by buying PacBio, we're now going to get, you know, a really big footprint in the long read space. And if you think about Illumina's business model, they're so heavily embedded worldwide. I mean, their market teams, they've got 22 offices global. And many times they'll have a bunch, one of their clients will have a bunch of their own Illumina machines and then one or two PacBio machines. This is going to give them an opportunity to really introduce PacBio to a lot more people right ahead of some really interesting technology that PacBio was about to launch. Next year, they were planning on launching a brand new chip that could significantly increase throughput for long read while also decreasing prices, making them far more competitive with short read.
Yeah, so you've got them now expanding on the technology front and to trying to get ahead of the competition. And speaking of competition, I mean, this is a field that's increasingly becoming more crowded. In addition to, you know, PacBio, thankfully now they've acquired them, you've also got Chinese company BGI, you've got Oxford Nanopore Technologies, Roche, Thermo Fisher Scientific, and they're already offering sequencing and molecular diagnostic products and services. Amgen actually took out a recent equity stake in privately held Oxford as well. So they're now getting into the game. So it's interesting to see big biotech jumping up to the playing field. And also, too, on the focus of BGI, they plan to offer a human whole genome sample sequencing in less than 24 hours, and it costs less than $300. By 2020, BGI can already perform next generation sequencing for close to $600. So again, I mean, Illumina, as many of our listeners will know, is really trying to continue to bring down the cost of gene sequencing, but their competitors are right on their heels. I think this makes a really smart and strategic move just to try to stay ahead of the competition.
You know, and too, Shannon, another thing that's important is a lot of times when you're doing the long read sequencing, there are drawbacks to both short read and long read. Long read is not perfect by any stretch of the measure. And a lot of times when you'll do long read, you'll also do short read to fill in the gaps for where the long read doesn't really come up with the information you need. So, you know, the idea of being able now to have a one-stop solution where you're able to get my long read done by Illumina and my short read done may give it a competitive advantage against some of those other companies that you were just talking about. And that could become increasingly important because, you know, by PacBio's estimates, the market that they were targeting is going to grow from about 660 million last year to 2.5 billion by 2022. That's significant growth, especially when you consider that Illumina's sales are tracking about 3 billion. So this could be, you know, almost equal to where they are today, just in additional long read sales.
And Todd, I'm going to use the word synergies here. I hate that word when it comes to M&A, but this is actually one instance where I think the synergies could happen, actually happen for a change and actually make sense. But what else should investors be watching, especially when it comes to PacBio?
Well, PacBio's had some delays in product launches in the past and some stumbles, if you will. So it'd be really important to see how that progresses. You know, this deal won't close until 2019. It does, you know, we still have to obviously get approval for this combination. Like I said, Illumina is the market share leader. Now, Illumina was asked this on their conference call, you know, do you think you can get this through regulators? From Illumina's perspective, the answer is yes, because they are a short read company and PacBio is a long read company. It'll be interesting to see if regulators agree with that assessment. You're also going to want to see then, once the combination is done, can they deliver on the timeline of releasing this new technology from PacBio that will indeed drive down the cost and increase the speed, making it more useful to researchers. And you mentioned the word synergies. I think most of the synergies are going to come probably from scale and from manufacturing and that type of thing. They're not saying at this point what the impact could be on the bottom line in 2019, but investors should know that, you know, PacBio is losing money. So, you know, integrating it will create some sort of a headwind that's going to have to be offset either by increased sales growth because of greater penetration in the future from these new products or from some cost cutting somewhere along the way.
So lots to look forward to in 2019. It is really setting up to be a crucial year, not just for biotechs, but also on the gene sequencing end as well.